Good morning. I'm gonna see how much I can squeeze in for you guys before the kiddos need me. So starting at the top of your mat, you're gonna need some washcloths close by, as well as some hand weights and some water, of course. We'll start at the top of your mat, reaching out towards the ceiling. Feel that side to side stretch. One more big breath, and then we're gonna start with those single leg burpees, inching our way out to our mat in that tall plank. So we'll start on the right leg. It's nice and heavy. That left leg's gonna be behind you. Level one, if you need more support here, you're just gonna put that big toe down through your left foot. That's gonna act as a kickstand to help you as you start to go down towards the mat. Level two, you can float that left foot behind you. Stare at something in front of you. Start to bend at your right knee, pulling in the navel here, nice and strong through that right leg. And then you're walking out into that nice tall plank, keeping that left leg floating. And then you're gonna twist to bring the left knee towards the right elbow, and then to the left, send it out behind you, and inch our way back in. Soften up that right knee as you start to stack your weight back over that right heel and slowly come up here. We're gonna do a total of five, so four more right here. Catch that balance, slow it down. And then inch your way up. Pull the navel in towards the spine, shoulders out of those ears. Really activate the core muscles. Nice and slow, three more. Stay with it. Nice and heavy through that right quad. Fire up your glutes. Activate that twist. Squeezing tight, navel up towards the spine. Just two more here. Leaving that slight bend in the right knee, even as you stand up. So really putting heavy tension on that right quad. Just warming up through our whole body here. Last one on this side before we switch. Nice job, use that breath. Big twist on this last one. Send that left leg behind you. Now let's switch sides. Now something that I didn't mention, level two, if you don't have that bum neck like I do, you can add a push-up at the bottom. In that nice tall plank, after you bring that knee in, you can add that push-up as an extra challenge. So don't wait for me to cue your challenge. You add what you need through your workout this morning. So four more on this side. Keep those hips square. Don't let those shoulders creep up towards those ears. Nice and strong through your lats, through your shoulders here. Three more. Don't talk yourself out of it. See if you can stay strong this whole time. You'll get to shake it out after. Just two more. And then we're gonna hold our tall plank. Keep that core nice and steady. Strong, that's gonna help you lower down with control. Big twist, shoulders out of those ears. Just one more here, at least I think. Too busy blabbing away. Nice and slow. Squeeze through that left leg. Last one, and then we're gonna bring it into that tall plank after our twist. So just send that foot back. You're in a nice tall plank here. I want you to hold it. Engaging that place underneath the armpits, squeezing tight through the shoulders, lengthening and squeezing through your glutes here, navel towards your spine. 10 more seconds, we're gonna drop to our forearms. Yes, you can. Stay with me. Just five, four, three, two, one. Forearms come down. Now shoulders are out of those ears. Palms can face the ceiling for a challenge. You've got this. We're holding it right here. And then we're gonna add those leg lifts in three, two, lift that right leg up one, slowly down, then the left, slowly down. Stay with me, try not to pike those hips up towards the ceiling. Pause with that leg up, final 10 right here. We're gonna go into that right leg. Yes, you can. For five, four, three, two, and one. Nice job. So grabbing one of your washcloths now. I'm gonna make sure you have your weights nearby because we're gonna get into some squats after this. So starting with our right leg here, you want that washcloth underneath your left toes. We're gonna do a front lunge. So your right leg's gonna be out in front of you. I want you to square off to whatever direction you're facing, whether it's a wall, whether it's your phone, the TV. And then, got that right foot out in front of you, left toes on that washcloth, you're gonna lower down if I don't have something in the way. All right, so lower down, bending at your right knee, floating through those right toes if you can, so no pressure there. That right knee bends directly over the right heel. You're gonna use the power of this quad and hamstring and the back of the leg to stand back up. Two, three, four. We're a little bit fatigued already from those single leg burpees, so stay with it. Slowly down. Two, three, four. Slowly up. So squaring off your hips in front of you. Those hands can come out if it's there. Otherwise, on your hips, you're allowing that upper body to pitch forward. Pull the core in nice and strong. A few more, just like this, nice and slow. Dropping those shoulders. We're gonna hold it down after two more. So one right here. Oh, Riley wants to be in our workout today. We'll stand it up. Two, three, four. Leaving a little tension through that right quad, so try not to lock out the right knee. And this last one here, we're gonna hold it down nice and low. Reach those hands out if you can, and then tiny pulse. Up, down, up, down. So don't put pressure forward. Keep sinking back. Up, down, up, down. We're gonna finish at that full range of motion in just five, four, three, two, nice and slow up. Slowly down. Two, three, four. Last 15 right here. Really root down through that heel. Fire up all that intention through the right leg. Core is strong and it's not leaning over so much that you're resting on your leg. Just five. Four, three, two, and one. Nice job. Now I want you to grab your hand weights. We're gonna get into some squats here, incorporating some arm movements. So feet are hip distance apart. Feet are parallel in front of you. You're gonna start with those weights right here in front of the armpits, elbows bent. Drop those shoulders. Inhale as you start to lower down. And then on that exhale, one punch. Doesn't matter which arm, we're gonna alternate. So sinking down, just like you're sitting on a chair, get low. Punch forward, fire up that shoulder. Slowly down. Exhale, punch. Send your pelvis in front of you, tuck the tail. Exhale, punch. Inhale, lower. You're on your heels. Weight is distributed evenly, even though that right leg is more fired up right now. Squeeze, lower. We're gonna hold it low in 10 more seconds. We're just gonna punch. Drop those shoulders, squeeze the belly button in towards the spine. We'll stay low on this next one. So right here, nice and low. Don't let that chest come forward, right? So sink back into those heels. Chest is up, punch, punch, punch. We're gonna switch it into a bicep curl. In three, two, and one. So those arms are gonna come out in front of you. Squeeze them in, and then slowly lift up, and you'll unfold those arms. Exhale, lower. Options here, depending on what your back can handle. So if you can keep those elbows up in line with the shoulders, great. If you need to bring them down a little bit lower because you feel it too much in your mid-back, that's also an option. I'm working through this gnarly neck injury right now, so not really able to do a ton of push-ups or a ton of like heavy weight upper body exercises. So you'll see me modifying a lot, and there's nothing wrong with that. Just challenge yourself. Let's hold it down on this next one. Challenge yourself in your form. So tiny pulses right here. Sink lower. We've got this. Just breathe. Final 10. Drop the shoulders out of your ears. Pull the belly button in. Keep that chest up. For 4, 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. So we're going to hold on to a weight. If you don't have hand weights, you can do this without. You can do it with water bottles. You can do it with your kids' toys. You can also squeeze a small ball behind your knee, because we're going to get into like a bungee like movement, just like we do on our body rock reformer. So putting the weight or a small ball or whatever you can find to add a little extra tension, or again, you could do this without anything. So tabletop your back here, drop the shoulders, core is tight, those knees are right below your hips. You're gonna hold on to that weight, flex your right foot, and try to keep all that weight towards that right side. Hips are square here. Super important, that's the hardest thing, right? Now try to keep tension on that right leg the whole time. So try not to bring the right knee all the way down. Exhale, squeeze that weight. If it doesn't feel right, just do it without. Nice and slow. So really trying to fire up that hamstring, squeeze the glutes. If you can, try to keep that neck nice and long, so ears over the shoulders. Try not to lean the body over towards that opposite side on the left. We're gonna pulse it. Really stamp your footprint against that ceiling. In 3, 2, 1, pulse it up, up, up. Yes, you can. Last 10 right here. We're gonna go into that fire hydrant. Bring the knee out to the side. In 3, 2, 1. So bring it in. Reset yourself if you need to. Put something under that left knee if it's bothering you for any reason. We're gonna be here for a little bit longer. Now squeezing through that outer thigh. Slowly in. So resist that knee back in. Don't send it out and let it fly back home. Out, 2, 3, 4. Slowly in. Strong through that shoulder, your lat. You're still keeping those hips square. So even if you're on your forearms here, stay with me. We're gonna pulse it out to the side here too. In 3, 2, and 1. Pulse it up, up, up. My leg's shaking. I don't know about yours. Whew. For 10, squeeze that weight, pulse. Stay with me for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice job. You're finished with that right leg for now. We're gonna get into a tall plank, twisting it to get into that right oblique. So grabbing both of your washcloths for this one. And what I'd like you to try to do, if it doesn't feel good, crossing your right foot over your left, just turn your toes and feet and hips over to that left side so we can get into that right side. I'll show you what I mean. So coming out to a tall plank right here. Let me just make sure I'm in the camera view here. And then your toes should be on those washcloths, shoulders down. Now what I mean is you're just turning your toes and your hips, your knees, keeping that upper body square. Let's see if I can do this with my sweaty palms. Exhale in, slowly back out. 2, 3, 4. Squeeze, exhale. Whew. Stop those knees right underneath the hips. Yes, you can. You should feel this on that right side of your body. Getting into that place above our hip, our obliques. Shoulders are down. If you need to modify this, you can always drop to those knees. Keep them open towards the same direction. Stay with it. We're gonna come to a forearm plank. 10 more seconds. Just 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I'm gonna find my mat with my towel here, coming into a forearm plank for single hip dips, just to that right side. Trying to come up with clever ideas to get into our obliques. There's not a ton of options like we have on our reformer, but I'm sure we'll come up with more here. But staying with it, hip dips are so effective. You could also do these from your knees. Keep those shoulders down, keep them square. Just hip dipping to the right side. Back to center. Last 10. Stay with it. Yes, you can. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. Quick little stretch here. Quick child's pose. We're gonna get right back into that front lunge on the left side. So grabbing your washcloth again. This time it's gonna be on those right toes. Front lunge, left foot forward. Let's see if I can position this right. All right. It's hard when you're sweating, right? You get a fresh one. All right, so left foot forward. Right toes behind you on that washcloth. They're squared whichever direction you're facing. And you're just gonna slowly press out. Exhale, squeeze through that left leg now. It almost feels fresher, even though we've got those squats. We didn't come right out of our burpees into it. So really fire it up. Keep that left knee over your ankle. Squeeze and root down, anchoring through that left heel. Hips are square. Don't let them open up. Exhale to rise, keeping a slight bend in that left knee. Inhale, lower down. You're allowing the upper body to pitch forward just a little bit. Protect your back so you're not going like this. Exhale, lift. If you decide where to put those hands, just don't put them on your leg and try not to bring those shoulders up. We're gonna hold this next one down. Send it into those pulses. So coming down nice and low. Reset if you need to. I'm slippery, I'm sweating. I hope you are too. Let's pulse. Up, down. Up, down. Stay with your breath here. Try not to come too far up. You're keeping constant tension on that glute, hamstring, and your quad, so much of this upper part of your leg here. We're gonna come to full range and finish it there. In 3, 2, and 1, slowly lift up for 2, 3, 4. Slowly down, 2, 3, 4, just 15 seconds to go. We've got this. Drop your shoulders, drop your intentions here. If they're high expectations of yourself, set an intention that's realistic. Stay with that one. Don't have these high expectations that let yourself down. We're all trying to survive this. Just 3, 2, 1. And I know you can do this workout. We're just trying to survive being stuck inside. All right, we're done with that front, those front lunges for today. We're gonna do plie squats, a little more upper body. So you wanna have those feet turned out towards the corners of the room. Your knees are gonna follow that direction as you take it down. So we're gonna go into that high row motion. I'm gonna come onto my mat because my feet are sliding. So bring them out wider than hip distance, your feet. And then those weights out in front of you, palms face your body. And we're just gonna take it down nice and low. You wanna keep your wrist in line with your elbow. So try not to do this, right? Just keep everything in line. And then exhale, press through those heels. Activate your inner thighs here. Squeeze. Lower, single lower. Press up. Staying with that breath here. Nice job, core is tight. You're dropping those shoulders and keeping your chest lifted. So trying not to hunker down towards the floor, leaning over, keep it back. We're gonna stay low, In 3, 2, and 1 on this next one. Drop it all the way down, staying nice and low. Hold your elbows back, squeezing that row in, shoulder blades together. You're gonna lift that right heel and just pulse. Breathe. Yes, you can. Try not to come up higher, stay low. We'll switch to the other side. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, switch it over. Yes, you can. We're gonna go into a quick lateral raise. We'll rise all the way up. In 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. So staying just like this. This time those arms come out in front of you, kind of in your peripheral vision, so not behind you, not way out in front of you. Although if you need to adjust for comfort, you can certainly do that, bringing them out in front of your body. I'm gonna keep mine out to the side. Squeezing your shoulders. Slowly lift. Yes, you can, we're almost there. We're gonna get into that glute and hamstring. I don't know what happened to our sunshine. It was super bright in here before. Let's hold this next one down. So hold it down right here. Sink to your lowest point. Squeeze through your inner thighs, through your glutes. Pulse those arms. Stay with me. Drop those shoulders out of your ears. Pull the navel in for 10. Stay low. We've got this. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stand up, shake it out. Whew. Let's get into that bungee on the other side. So you've got one of your weights or whatever you were using before. Coming into that nice tabletop position, bringing your weight behind that left knee, and then setting yourself up in your nice strong tabletop. So try not to round your back. Keep your core nice and tight. Hips are square to your mat, as are your shoulders. And then we're gonna just bend that left knee 90 degrees, keeping your left foot nice and flat, and press up. Slowly down. Whew. This is what I needed today. I hope I can bring you the same kind of joy and release. Still a little awkward to be filming yourself, but I miss Body Rock so much, just as I'm sure all of you and all of our members do. And if this is your first time trying a Body Rock like workout, welcome. Stoked to have you. We're gonna pulse it up in 3, 2, 1. Pulse it up, up, up. Use your hamstring and glute together. Squeeze. We're gonna open out to the side. Try not to lean into that right side. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hey, buddy.
I don't play my iPad anymore.
That's okay. This is Pierce. If you don't know, he turned 4 yesterday. He's my youngest. You say, I turned 4 yesterday. So in this one, your knee does come down a little bit more. Although if you can keep that tension up, great. But your goal is to not lean your booty and your hips over towards the right side. Stay with it. Squeeze through that outer thigh.
Who was the doggy too?
The video camera. We're going to pulse it up in 3, 2, 1. Pulse it up. 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 Last 10. You've got this. Breathe. Don't hold it in for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo. All right. Getting into that twisted cannonball now. So, we're gonna have those hips open towards you this time. So, getting into that left side. Nice strong plank. We're twisting at your hips, keeping your shoulders and your head square in front of you. Exhale, bend it in. Inhale, press out. I just came up with an idea because we're sweating so much. My towel will be slippery. Let's try this. There we go. That works really good. Exhale in. Inhale, release. So open up those hips as much as you can. Pull those knees just under the hips. Try not to pike the hips up as you do it though. Not like that. Keep them at shoulder height. Exhale in. Inhale, release. If you can do those push-ups here, I want you to add them in every time you press out to that tall plank. Stay with me. We've got those hip dips just on the left side in 10 seconds. Stay with me. We can do this in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So good. All right. Forearms are down. Palms face up. You're in your forearm plank here. Always welcome to do this from your knees. Dip those hips to the left. Back to center. Left. Back to center. Staying with it here. Squeeze through that left side. Last 10. Pause there for a second, then bring it back to square. Drop those shoulders for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So good. We're almost at 30 minutes, so we're gonna add in some bridge. I'm just stoked that I could get to this point with you guys without too many interruptions. So what I want you to do is, if you have a pillow, or if you have a small ball, because you have small children like I do, I want you to grab a ball about this size. Maybe it has a character on it, maybe it doesn't. But we're gonna come down to lying onto your back. And you might want to have those weights close by. I think we're gonna add them. So lying down here, make sure I'm in the camera for you guys. And then you're flat on your back, pressing your spine down here. We're gonna have that ball right in between your knees. It can be a little bigger than this if you don't have one quite this small. It really doesn't matter. Just something so that you can still keep your knees in front of your hips, and something that you can squeeze on so it's a little bit soft. From here, I want you to roll your pelvis in towards your navel, and then slowly start to peel your spine up off of your mat. Press those hips all the way up. Hands are down, pressing into your mat, so to keep those shoulders away from your ears. And then you're just slowly lowering the hips. But I want you to really imprint that spine. So it's not just bringing the hips down. You're doing that motion of rolling the pelvis, peeling all the way up to the tips of your shoulder blades, sending those hips all the way up. Pause there. You're holding onto that ball. So really squeezing your inner thighs. And then you're rolling down from the tips of your shoulders, mid-back, low-back, releasing your pelvis. Still squeezing that ball the whole time. Stay with me. Stay strong. We've got this. We're gonna feel so much better after this. Another day trying to make the most out of our health, out of being indoors. We're gonna hold it up in just one more. So lower down on this one. I'm so sweaty, you guys. This is great. Press all the way up. I have to keep repositioning myself. All right, so holding this next one up, you're really squeezing tight onto that ball. Shoulders are down. Don't let your knees press out. That's the great thing about having something in between. Again, it can be just a pillow. Now I want you to pulse your hips down and up, all while squeezing onto that ball. Activating through the glutes here. Squeeze. Lower an inch or two. Squeeze. We've got this. Breathe. We're gonna hold this next one all the way up with those hips. Squeeze the ball, little pulses. Yes, you can. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Last 10, don't let those hips drop. I want them all the way up. Stay with me. We'll lower all the way down in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lower down nice and slow. So good, you guys. Got us just to about 29 minutes. What do you say? Plank challenge, let's make it a full 30. Forearm or onto your hands in that tall plank. I want you to hold it right here. Keep it nice and strong. Stay with me. Let's make the most of our 30 minutes. Make it all count. So when you're ready, if you want to add on to this, crossbody mountain climbers, they can be as slow or as fast as you want to take it here. Just don't pick those hips up. See if you can keep your core so tight and really pause with that knee drive. Yes, we can. Stay with it. We're all gonna drop to our forearms here in 10 more seconds. Pick up that pace if you can. Just 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Forearms come down. Let's see. We've got this. 15 seconds. Stay strong through that center core. Fire up your legs. Dropping your shoulders. keeping your breath, trying to slow it down, even though we just picked it up with those mountain climbers for 5, 4, 3, 2, child's pose. So good, so good. So bringing your toes together, knees out nice and wide. Big breath, trying to lengthen those arms out in front of you. Whew. Being sure that you do add some stretches in here. So whether you take it into that pigeon, or that happy baby, or that twist, or some supported floor lunges, just being sure that you take a few extra minutes if you have it, even if you stretch with your kids. I hope you have a great day. Stay healthy, stay strong. I'll see you next time.